Hi everyone, welcome to another video. Today I'd like to answer the topic on why new launches are more expensive than resale. So one of the main factors why new launches are more expensive is because of the land cost. And in order for the developers to generate revenue, they need to build and sell their properties because this is their core business. So they will need to buy land. But the thing is, there are only two options to buy land in Singapore. It's either they get the land supply from government land sale, which is the GLS, or from collective sales. The GLS basically is land sales upon URA releasing parcel of land for tender. And usually the developers will have to bid for it because of the demand. Or the developers can also choose to buy land from collective sale, which actually are the owners of the existing developments putting up their site for sale. And probably you may saw that before during in the 2017 and 2018, and en bloc fever actually happened. So why is the land cost will affect the new launches prices? First of all, we know that our Singapore naturally is land scarce. And because of land scarcity, which is an undeniable fact, that the land supply will be limited. And because of the demand of housing, and the developers need to buy land to build. Therefore, most of the time, developers have no choice but to bid higher for a potential land parcel, resulting their break-even cost will be higher. And besides that, there was recent announcement that the construction cost will be increased as well, mainly due to our migrant workers are badly affected by this COVID-19 pandemic. Thus, this will further pass on to our consumer. But there is another source for the developers to buy land with, which is the collective sales. However, this also depends on how much the owner is asking on their reserve price. Why is it so? Because it is important that their stated reserve price is reasonable and the existing property prop ratio is able for the developer to build more units or taller blocks despite other restrictions, so that the developers will still be able to make a decent profit margin besides paying their development charge or top up their lease, etc. Hence, the en bloc will then be successful. However, this cost may also be passed on to the consumers. But in the most cases recently, some existing property prop ratio is already maxed out. And very often, it's hard for owners to see this objectively, partially due to the non-stop championing on successful en bloc project sold at a pricely sum. Owners tend to collectively ask for too high a reserve price, resulting self-sabotage on their own en bloc potential, and therefore lead to unsuccessful en bloc attempts. So these are the main factors affecting the price point in the new launches pricing. And so here are some projects showing you an idea how much they have bought the land at, how much is their break-even cost after paying all the charges and construction costs. So this is why you may have seen some developers are pricing their launch sensitively and or giving some discount, especially during this COVID-19 crisis, so that they still can sell some units by lowering their profit margin during this time. But of course, these factors are not the only reason why new launches are more expensive than resale. Because we don't forget that the resale price we're seeing now are old price tag, which these developments were launched with their land cost and their break-even cost at that period of time. And mostly resale price had to be supported by the valuation, which I had shared in my previous video. Therefore, there is a price differences between the new launches and resale. So I hope this video will help you to have a better understanding why the new launches prices are more expensive than the resale. And this will come to the end of my video. And I would like to thank you this customer who raised this question to me. And I hope everyone is coping well after the circuit breaker. Some may be still working at home, and some may have already started their work physically in the phase one. So please do like, share, and subscribe to my video if it's useful to you. And comment below if you'd like to ask a question, cause I will be talking another topic about whether do we have an oversupply situation in Singapore in my next video. Cause one of my friends asked me, with so many housing dwelling, like HDB is still building BTOs, EC, private new launches lah, etc. in Singapore, will it be too overwhelming supply of housing? So I will do that in the next video, and this is a very heavy topic. Hopefully I can squeeze into one video and try not to be too long-winded. If not, may get boring again. So I will see you in the next video. As always, stay safe and take care.